Good day everybody. In this video I would like to talk about the effect of trees in soil mechanics. You probably already know that trees are very important for our environment and they're also very important for soil stability. So if you look at the trees, they have roots and those roots go deep in the soil and they will suck moisture out of the soil and make the whole soil mass relatively dry, which is good for stability of that soil mass. Another important effect of roots and soil is that these roots act as a reinforcement for soil, so they will try to keep soil particles together. So these are all good things, especially for slope stability when we have landslides. It's very important that we plant vegetation and we plant trees so that roots will hold the soil mass together. So today I also want to talk about something, let's say a little bit of negative effect of trees. Not really negative, they're always positive, but something that we need to consider in engineering practice. And for this particular case, we're going to look at soil which is called reactive or expansive soil. I'm not sure if you're familiar with this one. So this is the soil that is very, very plastic. It has very high liquid limit. And when it's wet, it's going to swell a lot. So it will increase in volume by several percent. And when the conditions are dry, the soil will shrink a lot. So again, so you will see lots of changes in the volume of the soil. So when it's wet, it's increase in the volume. When it's dry, it's decrease. So for this particular type of soil, it's very difficult actually to deal with this in engineering practice. And we're going to look at the effect of trees, what we need to consider when we plant trees around light engineering structures, let's say one-story houses or maybe roads like pavements. So what we need to consider. So first of all, let's start with this diagram here. So I would like to explain what reactive soil and how it behaves. So we have a relatively large soil mass. And somewhere at the bottom you see here groundwater level, so water is here, so this part is saturated. Then we have some capillary zone, and if we have clay material, and usually reactive soil, or we also call it expansive soil, it's mostly very high plasticity clay, so you'll see that this capillary zone is relatively high compared, let's say, to sand or low plasticity silt. And above that, we have a stable zone. So this is the zone that is not gonna move during change in the season. And this part, which is called active zone. So this one, part of the active zone. So this part will undergo lots of movement. And we need to estimate it before we design any buildings, and I'm going to have another video to show you that design procedure, how it works. So for this zone, we divide it into cracked zone and uncracked zone. Again, in the following up video, I will explain how we divide it into these two zones. So for the cracked zone, it's the one too close to the surface when the weather is very dry and it's very hot, cracks will appear right on the surface, something like you see here. So this is a very good example of cracks in reactive soil. If you have a house or something that you live nearby and you see this kind of cracks during dry season, this is not very good. This is not very good. This means that it's reactive soil, and over the next few years there may be some issues with the building or any engineering structure nearby. So you see these cracks, and then when we have wetting season, when we have rainfall, so all these cracks, all this water will go through the cracks. So when it's dry, so it will shrink, so it will decrease in volume. When we have rainfall, water will go through the cracks to this active zone and saturate soil, and then it will increase in volume, it will swell. So it's going to be like this. So what is important here is suction. And you may know that suction, it's a negative pore pressure. Suction is actually very good in soil mechanics for the stability of soil mass, because suction will increase the effective stress, and that will hold soil particles together. So suction happens when there is not enough moisture in the soil, and this is the effect of tree and tree roots. So roots will absorb water from moisture from the water, and then they will increase suction. That's why the actually soil around trees are very stable, because there is lots of suction there and it holds it together. So if we look at this data I took from this book. If you have time, you can Google it up and read more about suction and reactive soil. You will see that for gum tree, on average, gum tree absorbs or moves about 200 liters of water per day. So that's actually lots of moisture that is taken from the soil mass. So when there is not enough moisture, there is suction, so soil becomes drier, and then at some point it will begin to shrink because there is no water. So in the next slide, I will show you how we can estimate the suction and how we estimate it for reactive soils. And then I will show you what kind of considerations we should have when we decide to plant trees, grow trees near houses. This is a very good summary. You can see it here. The summary is taken from this article. If you are interested in this topic, you can read more. So when we deal with reactive soil, we usually don't use suction in KPA. You will see for many design procedures, we use PF, so suction, and we'll see these numbers. To estimate PF, there is this formula. So it's 1 plus logarithm of suction, KPA. So what we do is we can measure suction in the field, and then we estimate it. So this is what we measure, and then we estimate this value PF. So why I wanted to show you this table is that you will see that when values of PF is relatively low, so in this case, there is not really much suction. Basically, there is no suction because soil is saturated, and soil behavior consistency will be at its liquid limit, right? And this is what we typically see in normal soils after rainfall. Even in reactive soil, we can see the same thing, right? So at some point when suction increases, and you see suction will increase here to very, very high values like 1,500 to 3,000. So this is called wilting point of plants. So this means that there is no moisture for plants to take from the soil. And usually we assume that it's about this value. It starts this wilting point about 1,500 kPa. Of suction. So when it reaches this value, this means that these roots cannot actually get any water from the soil. So now let's do this exercise and let's estimate value of PF for suction when we have suction of 1500 kPa. So in this case, we'll just use the formula. So this value of PF will be 1 plus log of 1,500. So that will be 1 plus 3.17. So will be about 4.2. So, and this is what you see here in this table. In this table, you see 4.2 value here. So we get it from here. So that's how you estimate this value F. It's really important, especially when you do design. If you don't do design, you can just use a suction in kPa values, in kilopascals. So that's what usually used for research. In engineering practice, you will see that many engineers use PF. Okay, and now let's see how trees and roots can affect the stability of reactive soil, and we'll go to the next slide. So this figure shows you what we need to consider. It's not much, but this is something that we need to consider when we decide to plant trees next to light engineering structures, for example, one-story house. So this is very light structure and it can be actually lifted by reactive soil. So in this case, it's very important to consider this distance of H. So the way that it works is we need to first do some site investigation and we need to know what kind of soil is underneath. So if it's sand or it's something like very silty or low plasticity clay, usually there is not really much effect of roots on the stability of that soil because it's not reactive soil. So in this case, if you look at this chart, half of the H, and H is the height of the tree. So you see this one is H. So in this case, that's doesn't have to be very far away the building. But when we begin to deal with medium plasticity, higher plasticity, and especially extremely high plasticity, so reactive clay, it will be in this range. So for this particular case, once we know the plasticity of the soil and we can classify it, then we will decide how far trees should be from the building. And this is just a guidelines. So if we have clay which is high plasticity, so the distance should be about H. So H is the height of the tree. If we have extremely high, this means that if it's going to swell and shrink a lot, so in this case we need to take extra measures, and it's better to have 1.5 value of H distance from the tree. So now let's just do some examples so that you see how we can apply it into practice. Let's say that we have tree here, and tree it's 5 meters, or we have already building and we want to plant the tree. Doesn't really matter. So in this case, we have a building. So it's usually a one-story building, something very light. And then we just need to know this distance so that it's not going to affect the foundation of the structure. And let's assume that the soil we deal with, it's very plastic. It can be reactive. It's going to be swell a lot. I mean, it's going to swell and it's going to shrink. So we did some laboratory testing and we measured that liquid limit of that soil. Let's say it was 57 and plastic limit was 27. So we just need to estimate how far trees should be from the building, right? So to do that, we need to classify the soil. And this is a Casagrande plasticity chart. I have a few videos that describe how to use this chart. So you see here we have plasticity index and we have liquid limit. So liquid limit here is 57. We're going to find plasticity index, which is liquid limit minus plastic limit. 57 minus 27 is equal to 30. So now let's classify the soil. We have liquid limit 57 at here and plasticity index 30 here, 30. So this is the point. So we have a high plasticity clay. So high plasticity clay is here. So according to these guidelines, the distance should be at least equal to H. And H is 5 meters. So in this case, we make sure that roots are not gonna dry up the soil around this very light engineering structure, and it's not gonna affect it over a long period of time with swell and shrinkage. Okay, that's it for today. Thanks for watching this video. Have a nice day. Bye.